Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel and welcome to the second half of this beta fish theory. So up to this point, you might be wondering why I have to use geometry node to do all this. I can modeling for this. Maybe it could be easier depending on how good is your skill of modeling, but there is something you cannot definitely do with just modeling. So you cannot turn your model to be some like a fish generator. You just like one snap and the fish have totally different looks. Some of the fish have two tails and some of the fish are like a bigger, or some is like pretty fat like baby. Not even that, you can use some select area to combine with the animation so you can have more control of your animation. So that's the benefit of using geometry node to do your modeling. This video we will talk about how to make the material of your fish, especially how to make the fish scale have the individual color for each piece of the scale. And the next final video we will talk about how to make the animation for your fish, and this animation is built based on BBBN 19, and I will put a link down below so you guys can go watch even before the final video release, so you can make the animation by watching his video already. But his animation is basically all random. So what I have made some customization is I made the fish can swimming along with the curve, and you can mix that between totally random or with the curve, so you can make any kind of curve, like follow around any object that you wish. So in this case, I make it fish swimming around with a human. And furthermore, I can make the animation more suitable for our fish, because all these tails, it should be like super soft. Use some selection to make the body feel even softer. So that will be the main part for the final video. And then there's two more things. It's kind of like the bonus of this whole theory. How can we boost the performance from now it's only 5 FPS to be 30 FPS? Like what you see now is around 30, 25. So how can we boost that to be like super smooth? How can we make this to be a fish generator? Or you can say the multiverse of fish. Like in this video, the shape of this fish is constantly changed. So that's the second half of this theory. So now let's jump in. So let's do the material first. And first we turn off the fish scale because we will do that later. Okay, and just jump into the shader editor. And make sure you're on the fish material that we make earlier. So we already have made these two attributes that is defined from here. So let's go to the shader mode to see that. So now we have these two information. One is this point. It means the body is the darkest, and through the end of this tail will be white, and in between is the gradient. So we can use a color ramp to control that. So in this way, you can almost have infinite possibility to do things. First, you make a color ramp and you make a second color ramp and use that as color. So if I put this to be red and this to be blue, so you got this gradient. So if we plug this color to the base color, you will get your fish looks like this. And now if you want more color for your fish, just press this plus sign and make another color and try to change this gradient. And maybe you want the body to be one color, just push this over here. You get the idea. You can just like experiment yourself. So let's see the other attribute that we got. It's called this edge. It's looking like this. Can use to be defining the bone structure. So what if we mix them together? Use the mix RGB. And set this to be whatever is good for your mixing. Just so you can get the color like this. Or you could mix the other way. It all depends on if you put some color here. I don't want to get in too much detail because I don't want you guys' fish all looks the same. So I just give you the idea that you have like this too. You can use to mix. And there's another new attribute that I have been experiment with. It's looking like this. So if we mix them together, something like this, maybe like that looks better. Can get more detail and like this dot. So let's see how I got this attribute. It's from this area that I got. So let's see what it is. I use a group input and I separate them. The selection use this all part, which is mean all this outlined that we use that to grow. And I make that to be a curve and I resample that to be like a very large number. And then I transfer this attribute and use this spline parameter and transfer attribute, set it to be like this. So if you change this resample curve to be something like lower number or higher number, that will make different result. And although this number is really large, but because it's only a curve, it didn't make any face. So actually this count, even in the large number, it will not drag your computer down so much. And you will see something like this, but don't worry about that because later we will use the fish scale to cover that. Or you can use another ways to avoid that. Let's test about that. Take a math. And take this body and this attribute to the output and set it to be multiply. And what we want is the invert of that. So we can take a Boolean math and set it to be not. Like this, we can cut off some area that we don't want. Take this attribute out and you make a name for that as we do it before, and you name it the name here and you use the attribute in your shader editor. Okay, and if you change this, yeah, you can see the color behave differently. So now we got something like this. And of course you can use all this attribute for different use instead of just use the color, right? You can use that to be for the metallic or subsurface or the roughness. Actually, it's anything. But one thing is worth to mention is you can use some attribute or some noise for the alpha. Just test this. If I use this for the alpha, yeah, so you have a hide your fish and maybe you want to be invert. So take this color ramp and reset that and just plug in and make it invert. And because of I forgot to make my fish smaller, so the number will be not so ideally, so I have to make a math to offset that. So you see you can use this to make some part to be transparent. Of course, to make sure you set your material setting to be something like this so the alpha will work more properly. Then not just like that, we can use some noise to work with that. So let's see, noise texture, and we take a color ramp to make it bigger contrast and we try to mix this too. So set that to be lightened and you just like change this to be some value that is working even better than mine because mine is just like testing. Set this to be constant so it will work more correctly and make it 4D so easier to change the seat. So this is a second way that you can break your tail. Then you just make some nice setting for your principal shader to make it like the way you want. And then we talk about how to apply different material for different part on your fish. For example, this eyeball, or if you have make a mouth, you can make a different mouth material. And of course, we will talk about how to color your fish scale. So now the fish scale, the color will be the same as the body. because it's using the same attribute. So first, let's use the noise color to test what if we don't use the correct way to apply the colors to the fish scale. So if I use a noise texture, and if I just plug that to the color, you will see all this color but avoid this blocky fish scale. So what we want to do is capture the normal of this individual fish scale, so it will be applied one color on each face. Will not be like each scale have mixing with several color. We can leave like this for now. And then we go back to the geometry node, to the place that we have made our fish scale. What we want to do is capture some attribute. So let's take a capture attribute. And you can put it before or after the switch. I will put it before because if I put it after, it will be close when I close the fish scale. And if you put it before, even you close the fish scale, it will also apply the color on the body. So I put it before. Put the capture attribute after the switch. And this way, when you turn off the switch, you will not calculate things. Yeah, that's why I feel like so weird why my performance is so slower than before. Yeah, before actually I put it after, but this time I thought I might put it before, but it's not right. You have to put it after the switch. And I set it to be vector. I take a normal. Plug that in. And then set this to be face. And then we just plug the attribute out. Then I will name that to be skin. And then set this attribute domain to be face. So now we can try this in this modifier panel. Put the name in there. And take this attribute and name that to be skin. And try to plug this. So now you got this normal for this fish scale. The color will not mix together. If you try to plug this vector to the noise texture that we used to test, so the color is not mixing together anymore. Each fish scale will have one each color. So now we have this attribute, and with this noise, we can take them to mix with this point. It will mix this color ramp in different way. So take a mix RGB and set this mix RGB to be lightened, or you can try other mode to mix. Then plug this fact or color to this mix RGB. So now you can see your fish become quite different. And use a color ramp to boost up the contrast. And now you can just change your fish scale's color. You might think this noise is a little bit too long, so you can use a vector math to control that. You set it to be multiply and bring them back all to one first. You can just drag this number to make them suit your fish. So that's the way how you color your fish scale. And then we might want to use different material to color your eyes. If you have made the fish mouth, you can color that, use different material. So now let's try to apply different material for the fish eyes. Just try to make one material and new. Make that to be eyes and set that to be just black. And now go back to the geometry node. And right at the end, we have this section. Just copy the set material and bring that to be the after and set that to be ice. So now all your fish will be applied as this ice material. So we have to use a selection to tell the set material to be only select some part to be materialized. So let's try to find that selection. So we know we have a group input that have all the selection. Group input. So let's see. We don't have that selection. So let's make one in the edit mode. So go to your fish and add the mode and just pick the fish eyes. So if you have made the fish eyes as the same way as I do, you just leave your mouth on whatever part you want to select and press L, and then that will be select. Then now we make that as a vertex group, press plus. I just find out we already have made one. So anyways, just make this as a, let's just make another one. And after you name that, assign and try to select. So yes, that's the eyes we got. Since we are here, maybe I make a very simple fish mouth. That's not actually how I made that, but it can work like this as well. Just maybe it will look a little bit stupid. Yes, I have just made a very funny, cute and ugly mouth. So let's make that to be a new group and select that, press L and assign and select. Okay, so now we have this with this eyes group and the mouth group. Let's make sure the eyes group is correct. Okay, so we can actually delete that. So now let's go back to the geometry node. So now we have to bring the vertex group into the geometry node. So press N and make another two more new attributes. So this will be the eyes and this will be the mouth. And here we select eyes and we select mouth. So let's try to bring the eyes selection. So voila, we got this. The mouth actually looks quite beautiful already. We don't even need to give a material, but we can do that as a demonstration. I would like my eyes to be shiny. So I give the roughness to all the way. Maybe like one thing about this material that you use in your geometry node, it don't have really to be in your materials section. For example, if I delete that in the material list, it will still be applied on this geometry because it's being called from here. So what's here is actually not that important, but it's better that you bring that here because that will be more easy to you understand and more easy to you to call that out to make some change. So just to let you know that, and make a mouth. That's to make another one and call that to be the mouth. Just feel a little bit funny, this face. Use the selection. So now the mouth is white. Yep, I want it to be like a pink. And we can bring back the subdivision modifier and the solidified modifier. Yep, that's our fish. It's very cute. I really like this face. So now you can play around with the color or anything you want to do. And then we just have to make the animation for this fish so it can swim. So you change some color for your fish, we can do that.